Hello everyone, I'm Mansi Anand and I'm going to be taking your marketing lecture. And if you like this video, do subscribe to our channel for more updates, and you can also join our Telegram group for more information. So today's topic is targeting under marketing. So let's begin with it, targeting. In our earlier video, we studied about segmentation, that how a marketer divides the target audience into various segments and then tries to evaluate the profitability of each segment. So, in the process of targeting, the marketer has already divided the target audience into various segments. Now, the marketer tries to evaluate that whether each of the segment is profitable enough for him or her to cater to their needs or not. So, targeting is basically pinpointing that whether a segment would result in higher sales or higher profitability for the company or not. So let's start with its process. As we discussed initially, the marketer has to divide the target audience into various segments, which are need-based. So basically, a marketer has to look at the entire target audience and then evaluate the set of customers who are having similar needs. So group customers into segments based on similar needs and benefits. So first step is done. Next, moving on further, the marketer has to resort to segment identification. So basically, when the target audience is divided into segments, after that the marketer has to analyze details about each segment. So details like demographics, lifestyles, usage behaviors. So these are the details which make a segment distinct or distinguish a particular segment from another segment, and these are the characteristics which make a segment identifiable. So basically, a marketer has to identify the distinct characteristics or features of a segment. So after that, moving on to third step, segment attractiveness. So now our division process is done. So now what the marketer has to do is profitability of each segment, that whether a segment is attractive or not and fulfills the goals and objectives of the company or not. So in this step, factors such as market growth, competitive intensity, market access, the amount of competition in the market, does this segment has growth potential or is it going to be saturated really fast? So all these factors are determined here and they help a marketer to identify whether a segment is attractive or not. Moving on to segment profitability. After evaluating all these factors, the marketer can analyze the profitability that will accrue to the company from each segment. So the segments can be ranked on the basis of their profitability, and then it can be analyzed that how profitable it would be for the company to cater to the needs of each segment. So here the company has to make choice among the segments, that which one segment or which one's needs the company wants to cater. Segment positioning for each segment. So after making the choice among the segments, the marketer has to decide the value proposition and product price positioning strategy based on that segment's unique customer needs and characteristics. So now the segments have been chosen. Now the marketer has to evaluate that how to design such a product or service that would fulfill the need of this segment and result in a profitable event for the company. So basically, the marketer has to decide all these strategies, be it price, be it product strategy, be it communication strategy, the type of channels of distribution that have to be used. So basically, all the decisions regarding the journey of the product or service or the value offering from the company to the customer have to be taken here. After that, the marketer moves to segment asset test. So here in this step, the marketer has to test the attractiveness of each segment's positioning strategy. So the marketer already has a strategy. Now he or she has got to test this strategy. So in this step, pilot tests are taken, some initial or pilot products are provided to some of the people from each segment. So by doing this, the marketer analyzed that the strategies that have already been built, whether they result in profit for the company or not, or whether these strategies are fruitful or not. So basically a pilot test is being done in this step. So after that, marketing mix strategy. So now you have tested your segments and you have corrected all the errors that were being made. So now a final strategy has to be devised, a marketing strategy that would help the marketer to provide the value offering to the customer and derive profit for the company. So expand segment positioning strategy to include all aspects of marketing mix, such as product, price, promotion and place. So all strategies related to product, price, promotion and place are finalized and implemented. So targeting is nothing, just deciding that which segments are profitable for the company or which segments are not profitable for the company. So when you go to shopping, you divide your needs into various categories, like under clothing, I need this, under footwears, I need this, under groceries, I need this, and under electronics, I need such items. But you have some constraints, that is the budget. So according to your budget, you try to allocate your finances to each one of them, and then you analyze that, yes, I can do without buying any new clothes, I can buy new clothes next month. So you let go of buying clothes and you think groceries are the most important, that is why I'll buy groceries and spend most of my money on groceries. So similarly, that is what a company does, dividing the target audience into segments and then trying to choose the best out of it. Moving on to the requirements which make an effective segmentation criteria. So how do we analyze that the parameters on which segmentation is being done by the company, they are valid or not? So here we analyze the effectiveness of the criteria on which the company is segmenting. So these criteria are measurable, substantial, accessible, differentiable and actionable. So basically all the segments that the company is dividing the target audience into should be measurable. So if they are not measurable, the marketer won't be able to derive any information or any useful analytics out of them, and it would be really difficult to strategize. So that is why the segmentation criteria should be measurable, that yes, under this segment, this number of customers should come and they belong to a certain geographical location. This is their needs and wants. So basically they should be measurable. The financial data should be easily available about each of the segments. Substantial. So here in this step, the segment should be large and profitable enough to serve. It should not happen that yes, there is a segment which has a distinct need, but the number of consumers under that segment is not that large enough that it would result in a profitable venture for the company. So let's take an example. Suppose there is a company that manufactures footwear. So some people have exceptionally large feet. So company might want to cater to their needs, but still the number of such consumers is not that large enough that it would result in profit for the company. So that is why the company is not catering to their needs and manufacturing regular sized footwear. So there can be a segment which has a distinct need, but it might or it might not be profitable for the company to fulfill them. So the number of consumers under a segment should be substantial or much enough that it results in profit for the company. Moving on to accessible. So it should be easy to reach and serve the consumers. So let's say there is an apparel manufacturer and they want to cater to the needs of different people in North India. So in North India, the needs of people range from consumers in Kashmir to UP. But Kashmir being a really cold place, people have different needs there. And UP having a different climate, people have different needs there. So the apparel manufacturer might want to cater to the needs of people in Kashmir, but it would not really be that much accessible. So it would be really difficult to reach consumers in Kashmir. So company might decide against it. So that is why the segment should be accessible. Now moving on to differentiable. So the segment should have distinct needs or differentiable characteristics. So it should not happen that there are two segments which are having really similar needs. So there is no point in segmenting them if they are having similar needs. So both the segments or all the segments that a company is dividing target audience into should have distinguishable needs. Now the last criteria, that is actionable. So the company should be able to manufacture a strategy to cater to the needs of such segments. So it should not happen that strategy formulation is really difficult for such segments. So moving on further to levels of segmentation. So while evaluating different market segments, the basic factors that a firm looks at are the segment's overall attractiveness and company's objectives and resources. So I told you earlier that the marketer tries to evaluate the attractiveness of the segment, that whether it would be profitable for the company to serve that segment or not. And the other thing that the company has to keep in mind is its objectives and resources, that by catering to the needs of one segment, whether the company would be able to fulfill its objectives or not, or whether the company has appropriate resources or enough resources to reach out to a particular segment or not. So does investing in a segment make sense given firm's objectives and resources? So it can happen that there is an attractive segment. So it can happen that there is an attractive segment, but it might not mesh with company's long run objectives. Needs of such segment might not result in a profitable venture in long run. So the company should analyze all these factors. So let us move to levels of segmentation that you can see in this diagram. So this is a continuum showing possible levels of segmentation. So in this diagram, there are two extremes. On one hand, there is mass market, and on the other hand, there is customization. Under mass market, the company tries to cater to the needs of all the target audience as one. So the company assumes that there is no difference between the needs of different consumers, and it can provide the solution to consumers' problem by offering one single value offering. But here in customization, the company tries to cater to the needs of each individual customer. It assumes that the needs of each consumer is distinct and it requires different strategies to fulfill the needs of each individual segment. So on this continuum, there are four levels, that is full market coverage, multiple segments, single segment, and individuals as segments. So let us look at each one of them individually. So under full market coverage, a firm attempts to serve all the customer groups with all the products they might need. The firm ignores segment differences and goes after the whole market with one offer. So as I told you, under full market coverage, the company tries to cater to entire market with one solution. So the plus point of this segmentation is it creates a large potential market, which leads to economies of scale, which leads to lower costs, and which in turn can lead to lower prices for the consumers or higher profit margins for the company. So this might seem like a really good idea, but it is not so. So the downside of this segmentation is it can be done only by really large firms such as Microsoft, General Motors. These type of firms have such resources that it can cater to the needs of entire market. So these firms can cater to the needs of the entire market in two broad ways: either differentiated or undifferentiated. So under differentiated, the firm sells different products to entire market, whereas under undifferentiated or mass marketing, the firm provides one product to the entire market. So the distinction is on the basis of number of products or services that a company is offering. Undifferentiated marketing is possible when the market shows no natural segments. So in the eyes of company, there are no visible differences between various segments, so that the company does not produce different products for the market. Undifferentiated can be linked to example of Henry Ford providing cars in only one color, that is black. So Henry Ford once said, any customer can have a car painted any color he wants as long as it is black. So Ford offered car in only one color, that is black. So undifferentiated provided one single product to the entire market. So differentiated marketing usually results in more sales than undifferentiated marketing, as they are providing different products for the market, but it also results in higher costs for the producer. So moving on to the next one, that is multiple segment specialization. So under this, there is selective specialization by the firm, and a firm selects subset of all possible segments, each attractive and appropriate. So there are a number of segments, so the firm tries to select some segment or a part of segment from some segments. So that is why it is said that firm selects subset of all possible segments. So it selects those segments which seem attractive and appropriate to it, and then cater to their needs. So let us take the examples of Sabyasachi Mukherjee and Anita Dongre. They are really famous high-end Indian fashion designers. So they cater to the needs of both men and women, but they provide them with ethnic wear only. So they have divided the entire market into two parts, that is men and women. So under men, we can divide male consumers into people wanting ethnic wear and people wanting Western wear. In women also, we can divide women consumers into wanting ethnic wear and wanting Western wear. So these designers have selected some part out of both of them. So basically men wanting ethnic wear and women wanting ethnic wear. So basically a subset of whole segments. So this strategy has the advantage of diversifying the risk. So if one of your segment does not respond according to your estimates, you can always turn to the other one. So company can try to operate in super segments rather than in isolated segments. So rather than choosing one single segment and catering to their needs, a company can try to operate in super segments, like trying to select sub segments or subset of segments out of these broad classifications. So all these segments must have some exploitable similarity in them. As in this example, there was people wanting ethnic wear. So be it men or women, but they have a common need, or they have an exploitable similarity that they want ethnic wear. This can be divided into two parts, that is product specialization and market specialization. So under product specialization, the marketer has the specialization in product. So he or she is providing the market with a single product, but it can cater to the needs of different market segments. So one certain product, but different market segment. So under market specialization, the specialization is in market. So there will be one market or one customer group which has many needs that is being taken care by the marketer. So the downside of product specialization is that your product can become obsolete or new technology can take over it. Whereas in market specialization, the downside risk is that the one customer group that you are catering to can respond in against of your estimates or may suffer budget cuts or shrink in size. So example of product specialization would be a microscope manufacturer selling to university, government and commercial laboratories. So there is one manufacturer manufacturing one single product, that is the microscope, but selling to different markets, be it universities, be it government or be it commercial labs. And here the marketer has specialization in market, so catering to the needs of university labs but selling an assortment of products to them. So I hope the distinction between product specialization and market specialization is clear to you. Now moving further, single segment concentration. So under this, the firm markets to only one particular segments. So under full coverage, the entire market. Under multiple segments, many segments out of the entire market. And then single segment, only one segment concentration. So here the firm tries to know about the one single segment really intimately and deeply so that it can cater to their needs. So achieves a really strong presence in the minds of consumers, having deep knowledge of segment's needs. So when the firm chooses one segment and gains knowledge about it, it can enjoy operating economies by specialization. So it can specialize its production, distribution and promotion and enjoy economies of scale producing for one single segment. So it can earn a high return on its investment as the consumer would be willing to pay a premium for such products. So this premium would result in high profit for the company. So under this, the company caters to the needs of a niche. So a niche is nothing but more narrowly defined customer group require distinctive mix of benefits within a segment. Under one segment also, the company might be catering to the needs of a subset of that segment, that is a niche. Examples of this strategy are Revolution, a brand called Revolution, producing clothes for plus size people. So Revolution recognized that there is a need for producing plus size fashion, or all the other manufacturers who are producing regular clothes are not fully catering to the needs of plus size people. So that is why they identified a positioning gap and tried to fulfill it. Next, Indigo Airlines serves only low budget, no frills customers. So Indigo works by volume profit, serving to low budget customers. So there's only one segment, that is low budget customers. Here there is only one segment, that is plus size customers. In case of KFC, one segment, that is non-vegetarians, with a very small segment of vegetarians. Next level is individual marketing. Individual marketing can also be called as segments of one, customized marketing or one-to-one marketing. So under this strategy, the company treats every single consumer as one single segment having distinctive needs from each other. So here full customization is achieved. So Jerry Wind and Arvind Rangaswamy, they coined a term called customerization. So it is an amalgamation of two words, that is customers and customization, collectively becoming customerization. According to them, a company is said to be customerized when it is able to respond to individual customers by customizing its products, services, messages on a one-to-one basis. So if you are aware about an online website called The Sold Store, it provides merchandise of famous brands like The Avengers or merchandise related to other shows. So The Sold Store allows you to customize your own products. So The Sold Store allows its consumer to design their own products. So you can go to their website and select the color of the t-shirt and then put a design on it, or give them a design that they would put on that t-shirt, and you can have your customized t-shirts. So this is the level of segmentation that marketers are trying to achieve in individual marketing, that each individual customer would be able to produce their own product according to their own needs. So in 2013, Alan Solly also did an experiment where they allowed their consumer to make their own customized colors that they would provide to them. But there are many limitations associated with this type of marketing. That is, it is very difficult in case of certain goods like automobiles. So it is really difficult to customize a car according to the needs and preferences of the consumer. And it might not be profitable for the company to indulge in such deep and such individual customization. It raises the cost of goods. So consumers who are willing to pay a premium for their products can only indulge in customization. A customer requiring a low cost product would never go for customization, as he or she would not be able or would not be willing to pay for premium. So raises the cost of the product. So many a times customers don't know what they want. They think they want a certain design, but they might not like it when they see the actual product. So unless and until they see the actual product, they might not like it. So these kind of products can be really hard to repair and have little resale value. So this was all about market targeting. So I hope this lecture helped you in understanding these concepts. So if you want such updates, you can subscribe to our channel and be a member of our Telegram group too, for keeping in touch with us. Thank you.